doctors who treat gun violence. The fight started over an article by the American College of Physicians that called gun violence a public health crisis that needed immediate attention. The NRA dismissed it, calling the doctors self-important and telling them to stay in their lane. Dr. Joseph Sacrin, who is also a victim of gun violence, shot back, saying this, quote, as a trauma surgeon and survivor of hashtag gun violence, I cannot believe the audacity of the NRA to make such a divisive statement. We take care of these patients every day. Where are you when I'm having to tell all of those families their loved one has died? Just hours after that tweet from the NRA, a gunman opened fire at a bar in California, killing 12 people and wounding many more. Dr. Joseph Sacrin is a trauma surgeon at Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore, and he's joining us right now. And as I mentioned earlier, he's also a gunshot survivor himself. Good to see you.
And Thanks for having me.
Yeah, and your gunshot wound comes from when you were a teenager, right?
Yeah, that's correct. Well, first of all, thanks for having me, Frederica. I was a 17-year-old high school student, and after a high school football game, I was shot in the throat with a 38-caliber bullet that nearly killed me. And so, you know, at that age, when something like that happens, you know, I was really inspired to take that second chance and go into medicine, become a trauma surgeon, and then try to figure out how do we work at that nexus of medicine, public health, and public policy.
And then amazing. I mean, you had that fortitude, you were determined, and now here you are a trauma surgeon. And then you are seeing all too often, you're now having to treat gunshot, you know, victims. And so you and collectively with other physicians to say this is a public health crisis and that more needs to be done. You're challenging the NRA, you're challenging politicians, you're challenging people who can, you know, craft policy, and that you would get this response from the NRA. Tell me what that felt like. I mean, we saw your tweet, but, you know, what was your visceral response through all of this? Your motivation and then your response to hear the feedback?
Honestly, Federica, it felt horrible. I mean, you know, to hear that type of message from the NRA was a clear demonstration to me that they're not serious about really moving the needle forward on this issue. And we are facing a public health crisis. You know, every day the medical community has to deal with this, and we are on the front lines. And anyone that thinks that we're not part of the solution really doesn't understand how complex of a problem we're facing. No one single person or organization is gonna be able to really deal with this solution and ensure that we make communities safer all across America.
And what are you and the American College of Physicians challenging policymakers to do? What was your objective here in this challenge?
Well, my objective is that we need to come together as a group of stakeholders, and that includes the medical community, it includes responsible gun owners, it includes patients and families. We all need to come together, and includes policymakers, in order to ensure that we're able to implement appropriate common sense solutions. And one of the biggest things that we've been facing as a medical community is the moratorium over the past 20 years on gun violence research. And it's about time that we hold our elected officials responsible. We need the federal dollars appropriated to this disease in order to address it adequately and to address it with data.
Are you feeling at this juncture more hopeful than ever or more discouraged than ever that any number of the 9 suggestions that you all collectively have given will actually be entertained?
Yeah. Well, you know, as you saw this past week during our election here in America, we've had a number of candidates that have run on a gun sense platform. And so in that sense, I'm hopeful that Americans and our elected officials are starting to realize that the time for action is now. And, you know, the reality is, and I've said this before, is the worst part of my job is having to go into those waiting rooms and tell family members that their loved ones have died. And sometimes, Frederica, I stand there just watching the families. And I know that what I'm about to do is going to completely change their life. Mm-hmm. And, you know, sometimes the memory of those mm-hmm. faces are chiseled into my mind. So we are part of the solution. And for anyone to say that we're not, I think it just demonstrates that they're not really serious about dealing with this problem.
All right, Dr. Joseph Sacrin, thank you so much for your time. And, and I'm sure so many are so grateful for all that you are doing and giving and advocating for.
Thank you so much for having me.
Appreciate it. Thanks so much for being with me today. I'm Frederica Whitfield. The news continues right now with Anna Cabrera right after this.